poster presentation number 16, risk of obstructive sleep apnea and quality of sleep in chronic liver cell disease patients admitted to a tertiary care center, research by Pathirana NSW, Indra Kumar J, Matthias T, Priyachana P, paper presented by Pathirana NSW.
Good morning, everyone. Our study was regarding the risk of obstructive sleep apnea in CLCD patients who were treated in ward. So, as we all know, the global burden of non-communicable disease, including chronic liver cell disease, is on the rise due to a variety of reasons like aging of the population and improved healthcare. So at the same time, the obstructive sleep apnea has emerged as a new disease entity, which is associated with our own set of complications if not identified and treated early in the course, can lead to a significant patient morbidity as well as a significant healthcare burden. So even in the general population of Sri Lanka, obstructive sleep apnea risk is at about 16.8%. So we unfortunately we don't have any studies which gives us information regarding the risk of obstructive sleep apnea with the relation to chronic liver cell disease. So the main objective of our study was to identify the risk of obstructive sleep apnea in cirrhotic patients. This was conducted as a cross-sectional study in Columbus South Teaching Hospital. So if we move on to the results, we have 42 participants and 2/3 were male, and majority had high severity of CLCD with Child's Pugh grade C. And when assessing the risk of obstructive sleep apnea, there was 38.1% of our population belonged to high risk group of high risk group for obstructive sleep apnea. And between this low risk and high risk groups of sleep apnea, we have found in the high risk group, the prevalence of diabetes and hypertension was statistically significant. So in conclusion, compared to the general population, cirrhotic patients have high risk of getting obstructive sleep apnea. And with the increase in the severity of the cirrhosis, the patients are more prone to get obstructive sleep apnea. And at the same time, if the patient is having comorbid diabetes and hypertension in the background of CLCD, they are at higher risk of developing obstructive sleep apnea. Thank you.
Thank you. Now the paper is open for the questions.
What are the possible contributory factors for this CLD patients to develop obstructive sleep apnea? Did you consider presence of ascites, pathological ascites, whether that could be?
Yes, madam. We have found that when considering the complications of CLCD, the presence of ascites, it was statistically significant in the high risk group compared to the low risk group. So in calculating the risk of obstructive sleep apnea in the stop bank questionnaire, they use BMI as one of the components. So this ascites and increase like body weight could be a contributor factor in that way. And
thank you for the presentation.
Thank you very much.